What do you think of seeing that lad who arrives into the pub with the young Thai girl on his arm?
Well, that's
isn't that incredible? Isn't that brilliant? I think.
And it's
or Latvian or a Russian or a.
Oh yeah.
What do you think of that? But isn't that great? We should be allowed. There should be no people going. Oh well, look.
Well, no, we are allowed. So, but I think
you know, yeah. But it should be freer, shouldn't it?
As in.
It's happening more often.
They shouldn't pay for it.
Or a Filipino girl who falls in love with an Irish. We shouldn't be. I still think that when it's out there, it should be more out there.
Yeah. I met a man once and he told me that he was marrying a woman from...
Azerbaijan.
One of those countries.
Palace Henry.
Yeah. So he had to... He said he got in touch with her through email and then he wanted to video call her.
Oh yeah,
and she said
FaceTime.
She came back and said she couldn't video time yeah. him because she didn't have.
He's breaking
a
out
video.
The sweat and the shoulders. One shoulder's moving up and down as she's talking. Go on.
She didn't have. She couldn't email. She only emailed him back and said, "Oh, I can't do a video call because I don't have a laptop that has a video on it. So if you send me one, then we can do that." So he sent her the video with laptop, and then they started video calling.
He sent her a laptop.
Yeah, she couldn't see him otherwise. And then they started seeing each other virtually, and then he had to convert to Muslim to get married to her, which he did. And I says to him, "Oh Jesus, and how
old is this lad now?"
He was in his 60s.
And would he be slightly? Would he have gone to seventh class?
No, I'd say he was
bright enough.
It was well. I don't know. Was he in seventh class?
That'll become a real.
He says, "Yeah, I had to convert to the most." The only thing now, he says, "I'm not sure I'm fully converted because I still eat a bit of the bacon and the cabbage, you know." So I said to him, "Oh right, okay. And how? What's the next step?" You know. And he says, "Well, now the next step is I'm trying to get a visa here to Ireland." And I said, "All right." And he says, "You know, she doesn't speak English." And I said, "What do you be talking to her about?" So on the video call, she'd just be showing me the family and. They'd be showing me pictures of the hens and the chickens and the cows and the whole lot. And I says to her, "How does the conversation flow?" "Ah, grand, grand, grand." So anyway, he went over, got married to her.
Do we know which country? was it Far East or was it
Central?
Yeah,
it was like the
Russia?
Far East. Right. No, it wasn't Russia. It was like Far East somewhere.
Like Malaysia, Indonesia or Thailand, Cambodia.
Yeah, one of those countries. Yeah. And he came back anyway. The wedding was on and the wedding lasted... For like, oh, it's Marrakesh. Where's that?
Morocco.
It was in Morocco.
That's interesting now.
Not enough women now in Morocco.
So anyway, went over, had the wedding. The wedding lasted a couple of days. I was mad keen to know all about the wedding. So got the full details and she came back.
Moroccan wives.
And I was helping him with his visa, you know, or her visa. And I says to him, what's her date of birth? And he says, "Now, I'll tell you now, don't drop the pen when I give you the date of birth." I says, "I won't. How about you write it down?" So anyway, the date of birth was... significantly
what gives
significantly
gives a ballpark
what was the age gap
gives a ballpark figure what she was she
was
born in the 90s
born in the very early 90s yeah so anyway right the wedding was
so she was he's 60 and she's 20
but yeah so anyway she came back and I says well how's married life going oh not too bad Jesus she's not getting a grasp of English at all and I said all right and how's the wedding how's life working out you know does she like it here she does yeah she's a mighty woman for the washing you know she'd wait at the sink all day there washing the dishes and washing and washing and washing and I said and what else does she do well now he says I don't need to paint a full picture for you, he says. But she's good at washing and she's good at other things and she doesn't say much more other than that. And I said to him, and that's it. And is she going to learn English? I wouldn't be in any rush for her to learn it, he says. She'll be sound. That's what it is.
Is that a true story?
That's a fact. And a word for word fact.
That is magnificent.
So I haven't caught up in maybe 12, 15 years whether or not... they're still together.
The whole thing happened.
I said, does she leave the house to go anywhere? No, not much now, he says. I'd bring her into the supermarket every now and then, but she doesn't know a lot of the foods, he said, so she's better at home.
You see, that's why I think it's great if it happens in parishes around the country.
So, I mean, all he did was send her a laptop and look what happened.
And did you ever see her?
Never. I never saw her, but she did need a visa and I don't know if she got it in the end, but she did need a visa and she did get married to him because he went over there for the wedding and he did show me pictures of the wedding.
Well, and the fella says, whatever works.
Exactly.
Whatever works.
And what I'm thinking of there is that there was no extortion, there was no mafia thing being behind the laptop, there was no person imitating her, there was no stalkers.
He wasn't gaslight.
No
What's under- that word?
Catfished.
Catfished.
Yeah, there was ghost boxing.
There was no shadow boxing or ninja. There was no extortion. There was no money changing hands. There was no rich West of Ireland man paying hundreds of thousands of euro into a fake account in a Swiss bank account. There was no documentary made about it. It was just love.
Love, pure love.
I love it.
Well, whatever works.
Exactly.